Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're joined by Azure CVP, Julia White, for an in-depth look at Azure Arc, a new way to manage your servers, virtual machines, and Kubernetes clusters, even Azure data services on any infrastructure, any cloud, and at any edge. Now, we're going to take a look at how Azure Arc unifies management, governance, and control with your virtual and physical machines right from the Azure portal, and how Azure Arc also enables Azure data services to run on any Kubernetes cluster. And we're also going to take a look at recent updates across the Azure Stack family. So to do that, please join me in welcoming Julia White back to the show.
Woo! It's great to be back, Jeremy.
Thank you. So it's really been a huge week for Azure, especially when it comes to hybrid configuration options, really across infrastructure and data.
Absolutely. It's been a very, very big week, because every large customer we have is mostly running a hybrid environment. And that used to be defined by running applications spanning on-premises data center and the cloud. But now, customers have need to run systems across multiple data centers, multiple clouds, and the edge. So hybrid has moved from being this kind of single-dimensional experience to being multi-dimensional. And we're now delivering that next phase of hybrid capabilities by enabling Azure services and cloud practices wherever you need in a consistent way.
OK, so then how does Azure Arc now change the game? Can you explain more about what Azure Arc is and what it's solving for?
Yeah. So what we found is that the cloud has matured, and organizations have adopted cloud services. And many large organizations today have distributed infrastructures. Their resources may be hosted locally, on-premises, in various clouds across the globe. And there's different tools and approaches to managing those resources. So it's complex, and many of you lack that visibility across those siloed resources. You know, multi-geography and multi-resource management at scale is something that Azure actually already does natively with Azure Resource Manager.
All right, so how does this all work then?
Yeah, so as you're building a kind of a modern application that runs more distributed across clouds, on-prem, and at the edge, you need that single unified control plane to manage everything effectively and, of course, securely. So Azure Arc actually extends the Azure control plane and services to any resource within your environment. It gives you that single unified management control plane across infrastructure running your apps and data, whether that sits in Azure, on other clouds, or on-premises. And you can take advantage of resources running outside of Azure, map and project them into Azure, and you can also even write to them as well. So now it's easier for you to manage the infrastructure, the applications you have, wherever that is. And you can bring Azure innovation to any infrastructure and manage it all from one place.
All right, and this again, this goes beyond just monitoring and logging up to Azure, so you can essentially control any server anywhere like it was running on Azure IaaS.
Yes. And of course, you can even monitor with Azure Arc, but you can also interact with all of your servers, your Kubernetes clusters, right from within the Azure portal. So let me show you. So here in the Azure portal, I'll go ahead and select into Azure Resource Groups. And in this case, I'll choose my RGVM down here, this resource group. And when I go in here, you can see I actually have resources sitting in Azure. Those are the blue ones. But I have resources sitting outside of Azure, those purple ones. And you can see in the type it says Azure Arc. Now, I'll click into this one that sits in the data center. And even though it's sitting outside of Azure, I can use Azure services to do management and governance of that. So I can see I can use Azure Active Directory to manage access. Or I can go in and get that single compliance view. I'll go ahead and click in, and I can see that here's all my policies, and I have a resource that's non-compliant. Of course, I want to fix that. So I'll go ahead and click to my initiatives here. And you'll see I have three different policies, and I need to update the compliance on them. So go ahead and choose this middle one. And I've set up a few policies here to, in the case, do things like make sure that all my resources are using the same time zone. And again, not just seeing it, but right from here, I can go ahead and select this, and then I can create a remediation task. So that policy is now pushed down to the resource sitting in my data center, getting it into compliance right here from the Azure portal.
Very cool. So again, the nice thing here is that you've got this great view across all your resources, whether they're in a single location, multiple locations, aren't in infrastructure. And just to be clear, these could be virtual machines, they could be running on-prem, they could be physical servers, they could be going or running, I should say, in Azure, AWS, or the Google Cloud. You can see them and manage them.
That's right. I really mean anywhere. And it also means you'll be able to further modernize operations with a cloud-powered AI that's actually just part of the security and management tools of Azure as well.
Right, and this is a really great option also to manage policy and keep your resources protected. But I want to switch gears here, because we also mentioned that Azure Arc even brings Azure data services to any infrastructure.
Yep.
How would that work?
Yeah, so even Azure data services work here on existing hardware. This basically gives you the ultimate flexibility to run and manage your data wherever you want to put it. And we've started by bringing Azure SQL database and Azure database for Postgres to be able to enable this capability. So now I can literally go and deploy my SQL and Postgres SQL, even hyperscale capabilities, to any Kubernetes cluster, again, on any existing infrastructure. So here I'm in the portal again. I'll go ahead and click to my resource group. And in this case, I'll choose my Ignite 2019 resource group there. And when I go in here, you can see, again, I have databases sitting in Azure, but also extended out with Azure Arc. And I have SQL Managed Instance and my database for Postgres here, kind of using Azure Arc to be deployed on premises in other locations. So even though I'll go ahead and click on my Postgres database here, and again, even though this is sitting outside of Azure, I can actually scale it up using the hyperscale capabilities. So go ahead and configure that. And I'll put up my worker nodes, push those. I can push them up, what, 44? I know that's a number you like, Jeremy. Go to 44.
44 is great.
Yeah. Now I can also do vCores and storage. Those things look OK. So I'll go ahead and just save that.
That's like 3,000 cores.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Doing the math. And then I go to the rebalancing, and I can actually see right here from the portal the data sharding across those 40 new nodes that I just added in addition to the 4 that I already had.
Right. So is this going to work then the same way that we have in terms of like Azure Data Studio or CLI, where I can also kind of manage and do these types of things right now with data services in Azure?
Yeah, of course. I mean, these tools are actually calling the same APIs as the Azure portal. And the nice thing is that as an Azure data service is that it's actually kept up to date just like it is when it's running within Azure. So you get that cloud benefit on-prem.
Awesome. So now with this ability to run data and management services really on any infrastructure, I'm kind of curious now, where does Azure Stack actually fit into this?
Yeah, that's a question I keep getting. So Azure Stack is another important aspect of our hybrid capability. And it brings a consistent Azure infrastructure to any environment and can even work in disconnected situations. And Azure Stack now has expanded to become a family of products that extend Azure into their data center or right at the edge. And on one end of the continuum, we have Azure Stack Hub that is great for kind of full cloud-native applications. And it extends that consistent full stack of Azure services to reside within your data center. On the other end of the spectrum, we have Azure Stack HCI that's optimized for virtualized legacy systems on-prem, and it connects back with Azure. And then in the middle, we have our new Azure Stack Edge, which is designed for data processing, kind of AI inferencing right there at the edge situation.
And for those of you who aren't familiar with Azure Stack Hub, it's really the new name for the original Azure Stack. Now, it's fully optimized. It's purpose-built. It's integrated also the system that runs basically Azure services in your data center. So it works whether you're connected to the internet or completely disconnected. Mm-hmm. It's great for developers who want that kind of consistent environment, and it's autonomous.
Right. And think about a use case, right? Like a shipping company. We're considering ships are at sea, and they need to be able to run Azure services, but they don't always have internet connectivity unless they're maybe at the port. Or there's latency issues even when they are connected. They still want to be able to monitor, to manage operations real time on the ship. So they would run some operations locally with Azure Stack within each ship.
So again, this can work basically completely disconnected. It's really been great in the last couple of years to see the momentum here and how Azure Stack Hub can really solve for some really challenging issues like data sovereignty or also giving consistent experiences again for developers, for IT organizations with the public cloud.
Yeah. Now, sometimes you might just need edge processing, kind of lighter weight. And with Azure Stack Edge, it's built for that data processing, AI inferencing. It's great for data collection, rapid machine learning at the edge, and pre-processing data before you send it up to Azure. And then finally, we have Azure Stack HCI, which is a familiar and hyper-converged Windows Server 2019 cluster that uses validated hardware to run virtualized workloads on premises. You know, it's great for when you want to kind of refresh aging hardware or you want to consolidate virtualized workloads. And of course, my favorite, connecting back with Azure for hybrid cloud services using the Windows Admin Center. So here in the Windows Admin Center, I have my Azure Hybrid Services tool where I have one view of all the tools within the WAC that I can use. So I'm going to click in here. And you can see I have things like site recovery to protect my machines. I have network adapter, Azure Monitor for my whole environment, Azure Update Management, make sure everything's patched across my environment, backup to protect my data, file sync for effectively an unlimited file server, and then, of course, Azure Security Center to provide security across my entire environment wherever that might reside.
So it's really seamless. It's going to work basically anywhere that you need to have effectively management. In this case, the Windows Admin Center is awesome to use. So great seeing all the updates then across really Azure Arc and the things that you can do with hybrid management, data and infrastructure, and also the updates that we made across Azure Stack and the family there. But where's the best place people can go to learn more about all these great technologies?
Absolutely. We've been working on a lot of different resources for all the different hybrid capabilities. One place to go, azure.com/hybrid, and you get everything you need right from there.
And of course, also keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates. If you haven't already, hit subscribe. That's all the time we have for today's show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.